Chris Teal, co-director of the Institute for Creative Music and fellow song learner and jazz enthusiast. Today we're going to dig into more of this series of learning jazz by ear with a classic, staple of jazz repertoire by one of our tradition's foremost composers, band leaders, and piano players, the great Horace Silver. And so this is the title track off of the album Song for My Father, recorded in 1964. And we're going to start off by talking a little bit about the form before we dig into the bass line, and then the melody, and then improvisation. So this song, as we're going to hear in just a second, as we listen to the recording through the form, starts off with an introduction. And so we just get the piano and the drums and the bass. And so the bass and the piano are playing, a bass line, something that's more like an embellished version of something we would expect to hear from like a rock or a pop song. This is something, actually, this song has been influenced and cited by, like Steely Dan, Stevie Wonder, and other people. But it's a bass line that is just, you play the roots and you play the fifths, and then you embellish in between different chords with different passing tones. And so if you're looking to learn a great bass line in terms of not only knowing the root melody of a song, but knowing how to connect in between, in between the beats, in between the measures, and connect the chords together, this is a great example of a bass line that's composed. So the song starts off with an introduction by the rhythm section before the horn section comes in, trumpet and tenor saxophone, and then the form starts. And so when we learn our bass line, we're going to count the form as when the horns come in. There's a little bit of a pickup to that. Okay, so each of these sections are 8 bars long, which is fairly typical of jazz songs we've been learning, or just really any song. It plays 8 bars, it repeats it, and so we talk about the first section as being an A section, repeats, so we get A, A, and then there's a contrasting 8-bar section, which we call B, and then that entire form repeats again. And so as we go through the melody and just the song form, it's A, A, B, but then it repeats 2 times on the head. Okay, so let's just take a second and listen to the original recording by the Horace Silver Quintet, and then we'll break it down. So we mentioned that there's that introduction, and now we're going to start learning the root melody. And so not the fully embellished bass line the piano and bass are playing, but the root melody in the way that we've learned it with a lot of these other songs. And so this is going to be moving by in whole notes and half notes. Okay? So I'm going to play and sing through the root melody on the A section, just in long whole notes. I'm going to sing it and play it on the piano. Listen, and then we're going to do it together. So 1, 2. Oh, 1, 2, 3. So That's 8 bars long. And so I'm going to count out loud this time. So 1, and this time, actually, see if you can sing along with me, follow along. This is the quarter note. So I'll count out loud as we do this. So 1, 2, sing. 2, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8. Then it repeats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2, 3, 4. And there we're into the contrasting section. Okay, so just, you know, you've sung through this a little bit, but I forgot to ground us on our home note. So we're in the key of F minor. So that first note that we sing, that's concert F. Do. Go ahead and just sing that and get it back in your ears and your body. Do. Do. So the root melody starts on that pitch. And so we're going to call that scale degree 1. It's a minor key, and all of the root notes are diatonic to the minor key. And so a good reminder, if you're thinking of F minor, I'm just going to play up and down the scale. So we have, it's F, G, A flat, B flat, C, D flat, E flat, F, E flat, D flat, C, B flat, B flat, G, F. So even though, you know, we could think of like flat 7, flat 6, flat 3, a lot of times with jazz tunes, we just take that for granted, and I might end up saying, okay, we start on scale degree 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. The second chord is an E flat, okay? So to give us a sense, I might just call that 7. It's the lowered 7th, but it's a minor key, so we're going to keep that in mind. All right, so there's, let's see if you can find this. And so we know, so we go from F for 2 bars, then I gave it away. Okay, it goes down to E flat. It goes down by a whole step to E flat for 2 bars. And then the next one, 1, 2, 3, 4, short, 2, 3, back 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So to fill in the gaps, I gave you that we have F, and then to the E flat, the flat 7, and then what's that? Do, sing it, find another instrument. It's continuing down that natural minor scale. So it goes F for 2 bars, E flat for 2 bars, D flat for 1 bar, then we get a short note on the next note down the scale, which is a C natural. And then we go back 2 more bars of F minor. So let's see if you can play this A section. It just goes down that scale. Pretty easy to remember if we add that for shorthand. And remember, short note on, what is that, bar 6. All right, let's try this. So 1, 2, play and sing. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, and 6, 2, 3, 7, 2, 3, 4. Let's do the second time through. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so before we get to talking about like the embellished bass line that the piano and bass are actually playing, we're going to jump ahead and just do the next 8 bars of this root melody. It's straightforward. It's actually all the same pitches that we've used before, but it's just in a different order. Okay, so we have that filter on our brains. We're in F minor, so we're using, you know, so far we've just used F, E flat, D flat, and C. I'm going to sing and play through the B section bass line. Listen and see if you hear any similarities, but we know that that's scale degree 1. You want to ask yourself questions. Do I start on the same pitch? Do I start on scale degree 1? Is it something different? Is it one of those other pitches that we played? All right, here's the B section. Listen, ask, and try to answer some of those questions. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Do, do, do. Do, 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 2, 3. Okay, so if that's the home note, our ears should resonate that we end on that, but did we start on it? No. But we've played that before. We start on the seventh, so that's that E flat. So it doesn't descend all the way down that cycle. It goes on 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. Goes back to home for two bars. Then we go 7, 6, 5, 3, back to home. So that little shift that happens at the end, it's the same cycle. We go and then down to D flat and C, but it's two beats apiece. So to count through this B section, I'll do it, and if you want to sing along with me, and then we'll play it together. So, singing, I'm counting. 1, 2, B section. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2, 3, 4. Great. So it just moves a little bit more quickly. Before we get to bar 6, everywhere in this form, that break on your concert C. All right, let's try to play this. This is the B section. 1, 2, already B section. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2, 3, and. Great. Let's see if we can do the AAB root melody all the way through the form. Should be pretty straightforward, and then we'll get into this embellished bass line. It's a little bit more detailed. All right from the top, it's the same chords, just moves in a slightly different order. Remember, the B section starts on E flat, that lowered 7, or 7 within our minor key, and the A sections start on the root note. All right, here we go. 1, play it. Ready, beginning, go. 2 times total. If you need more review with that, go through and check it out. But we're going to go ahead and go into this more detailed part as we talk about it's not just the root melody, but it's more of a bass line. And so we're playing roots, but we're also doing a lot that embellishes that by playing the fifths of the chords and then adding some different chromatic motion to connect the chords. Okay, so that might mean a lot, that might mean nothing, doesn't matter. We're all going to learn this together by ear, by singing, and then putting it together. So this is going to give you a great example of a bass line and ways that you can construct things using roots, fifths, and some chromatic motion in between the chords. Okay, so we know our root melody, hopefully pretty well, but if you've listened to that recording, it actually anticipates the downbeat of the chord by starting with this 1, 2, 3. These chords, you're going to hear the chord change come on the and of 4, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and F minor. So listen to me, I'm just going to play through a somewhat embellished but still kind of simplified version of this A section bass line. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. So notice that those pickup beats anticipate the F minor chord, the E flat, and then the D flat chord. Do you notice I'm not only playing the roots of the chord, but I'm thinking within each of those chords and using very useful chord tones. And so I'm using the root, 5, find those, you know, singing it and then try to play it. So I'm just going to do, this is on the one chord, on the minor F, on the F minor chord. One, two, try it. And anticipate the E flat dominant chord. We go E flat, E flat. What's the fifth of that chord? E flat and B flat. Then we get the D flat chord, D flat. Just get that in your head. It's D flat and A flat. Then we just land on the C. But this is great. This is a composed bass line that Horace Silver is playing with his left hand on the piano and Teddy Smith is playing on the acoustic bass. And so if we connect this further, and if you listen, really focus in, kind of ignore the melody to what the bass and the left hand of the piano is doing, you'll hear this. So I'm going to play all the way through this. You should hear roots and fifths, but also there's going to be some cool ways of connecting them, what we call chromatic passing tones, connecting between these chords that are built between whole steps and different ways of embellishing back and forth. Here's the embellished bass line on the A section. One, two, three. Check out, and I actually didn't do a very good job of that, the articulation that the bass and the piano are doing at the bottom end when we're going down from our E-flat, D-flat to C, it's actually kind of short. Two, three. It's kind of short, maybe not quite that much, but listen to the way that they're phrasing it, and when you're playing this, whether you're a bass player, a piano player, or playing on a horn or singing it, try to match the articulation the way that they're doing it on the recording. Okay, let's see if you can try to play this along with me. This is the A section embellished bass line. So you can do it whatever octave is comfortable on your instrument. I'm going to try it this time up. This is like right below middle C. All right, so one, two, one, two, three, and. Section. All right, so we have an embellished A section using different chord tones. Most of this, it's like it sounds great, rocking back and forth, roots and fifths. There's that really cool, so that's the chromatic walk down. So we go from on that E flat, so it just adds a little bit of motion, and then embellishes it up with the fifth again. Okay, so remembering the B section bass line, it starts on an E flat. Listen, here is the embellished bass line on the B section. One, two, one, two, three. That down again, we go, it's the same sort of movement, roots and fifths. So it's one, five, five, one, one, five, five, one, one on the F minor, five, one, one, five, five. So that little last thing goes E flat, then D flat, E flat, E flat. E flat, E flat, ba 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 bo ba 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 to play it. And E flat, E flat, B flat, B flat, D flat, A flat, D flat, C, 2, 3, then back to F. See if you can play the B section embellished bass line with me here. For this one, also I'll do this version up the octave right below middle C. I think if you listen to the recording, the rhythm of this B section starts right on beat one. There's not a pickup. It's just 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's try it that way. You're free to do whatever you want when you're playing with your group. And I'm sure that they do it different ways on the recording. Let's just try starting on beat one. One, B section bass line. 1, 2, 3, and. Let's see if we can put this entire thing together. Feel free to go back and review any of these parts that you need, but let's see what happens if we go A, A, B, and then we're going to do another A, A, B, because that's the way the bass line works. We can use the practice. Why not? All right, so top of the form without the introduction. So this is right where the melody comes in. 1, 2, 3. Give you an idea of how to play not only the root melody of Song for My Father, but different degrees of the embellished bass line. Again, with all of these, learning the form, learning the bass line, learning the melody, go back to the original recording and try and pick up the way that they're articulating it, the way that the band plays it. You know, I'm going to demonstrate a lot of different things. I'll try to get as much as I can, but use those as your primary sources. All right. So check back next time and we'll get into the melody and then some improvisation. Happy practicing.